Hello students, this video lecture is on the subject information theory and coding, and in this class we are going to solve few problems on channels where we are solving the problems to find the mutual information and the rate of transmission for the given channel diagram or channel matrix. Two noisy channels are cascaded whose channel matrix are given by the channel matrix is given by matrix. So we have P of y by x, which is given as you have x1, x2, and outputs are y1, y2, y3. Fit the probability values as 1 by 5. 1 by 5, 3 by 5, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 6, and one more channel matrix P of Z by Y is given as Y1, Y2, Y3, and the outputs are Z1, Z2, Z3 with values as 0, 3 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 0, half, 0, half. So what we are asked is input P of x1 is equal to P of x2 equal to half. Find the overall mutual information I of x, y. So if you write the channel diagram for this, it looks like, so channel diagram, so we'll try to write the channel diagram for this cascaded connection. So you have input x1, x2, outputs are y1, y2, y3. So x1 to y1 you have connection, x1 to y2 you have connection, x1 to y3 you have connection. Similarly, x2 to y1 you have connection. From here to here you have connection. From here to here you are going to have the connection, and the respective probability values are, so from here to here the value is 1 by 5, from here to here the value is 1 by 5, and from here to here the value is 3 by 5. Similarly, from here to here the value is half. The next connection you have 1 by 3. The next connection value it is 1 by 6. Now this particular channel is cascaded to one more channel with output as Z1. So we'll write the output Z1, Z2, Z3, where Z1 by Y1 you don't have connection. From here Y1 to Z2 you have connection, Y1 to Z3 you have connection. Similarly, Y2 to Z1 you have connection, Y2 to Z2 you have connection, then you don't have connection from Y2 to Y3. Similarly, from Y3 to Z1 you have connection, from Y3 to Z2 you don't have connection, Y3 to Z3 you have the connection as per the channel matrix. And what are the respective probability value here? So from here to here the value is 3 by 5. From here to here the value is 2 by 5. Similarly, from here to here the value is 1 by 3. From here to here the value is 2 by 3. Then this value is half, and this respective next value is half. So now how to find the overall mutual information I of x, y. So x is the input, y is the output. So we have to find the mutual information. Now P of z by x is nothing but P of y by x into P of z by y. So this is 2 cross 3 matrix and this is 3 cross 3 matrix. So we are going to find P of z by x matrix. So how will you do this? We are going to do the matrix multiplication now. So 1 by 5, 1 by 5, 3 by 5, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 6. This matrix is multiplied with one more matrix Z by Y, which is 0, 3 by 5, 2 by 5, then 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 0, half, 0, half. We'll try to multiply these two matrix. So after matrix multiplication, we are going to get P of Z by X equal to, this matrix will be equal to 11 by 30, 19 by 75, 19 by 50, 7 by 36, 47 by 90, 17 by 60. So the respective channel diagram for this particular matrix will be, you will have two inputs, x1, x2, y, z1, z2 and z3 as the three outputs. So we'll have all the connection from all the inputs here. So we'll have the channel diagram something like this, and the respective probability values will be given in the matrix. So this is 11 by 30. So the next one is 19 by 75. The last row this one will be 19 by 50. This element value will be 7 by 36. The next row value will be 47 by 90. And the last connection here, that is Z3 by X2, will be 17 by 60. So this is the respective channel diagram. Now, we'll see how to find the mutual information. So we know that mutual information I of X, Z is nothing but H of Z minus H of Z by X. So we know that to find this H of Z by X, we need to have the joint probability matrix. So P of X, Z is nothing but we are going to multiply this one with P of X1, which is half, and this with P of X2, which is half, and we are going to get the joint probability matrix. So this will be 11 by 60. This will be 19 by 150. The next will be 19 by 100. The last row will be 7 by 72, 47 by 180, 17 by 120. So this is the joint probability matrix. Now we know that H of Z by X is given by the formula double summation I varying from 1 to R, J varying from 1 to S, P of Xi, Zj here into log of 1 by P of Zj by Xi. So we are going to keep 1 as the scalar quantity, that is this 11 by 60, and then finding the log of P of this particular value. So go and substitute this 11 by 60 into log of 1 by 11 by 30, 19 by 150 into log of this. So as we have done earlier, just put it in the formula, and finally we are going to get H of Z by X, which will be equal to 1.5137 bits per symbol. So this will be the I of H of Z by X. Now from the joint probability matrix, adding the column, we are going to get the output probability. So add the first column element of P of X, Z, we are going to get P of X Z1, which is 101 divided by 360. P of Z2, that is add the second column of P of X, Z joint probability matrix, you are going to get 349 by 900. And then add the last third column element of P of X, Z, we are going to get P of Z3, which is 199 by 600. So now by this particular probability value, we can find H of Z, which is summation of J varying from 1 to 3 here, P of Zj into log 1 by P of Zj. So it is nothing but simply J varying from 1 to 3 P of Zj into log of 1 by P of Zj. Substitute the value, you are going to get H of Z as 1.5725 bits per symbol. So this is the H of Z for the given problem. So now we can find what is I of X comma Z, which is H of Z minus H of Z by X. So we'll substitute here. It is 1.5725 minus 1.5137. So you are going to get the mutual information as, after subtracting, 0.0588 bits per message symbol. So this is the mutual information for the cascaded problem given. Next problem, determine the rate of transmission of information through a channel whose noise characteristic is as shown in figure below, given P of X1 equal to P of X2 equal to half. Assume RS is 10,000 symbols per second. So the noise characteristic is given as, so you have X1, X2, Y1, Y2, Y3, and you have the connection from here to here with probability value as 3 by 4. From here to here it is 1 by 4. From X2 to this it is half. And from here to here it is half. So we can write the channel matrix as P of Y by X equal to X1, X2 are the input, Y1, Y2, Y3 are the output. So we can write the respective values here. So you have Y1 by X1 as 3 by 4, Y2 by X1 as 1 by 4, Y3 by X1 no connection 0, Y1 by X2 there is no connection 0, Y2 to X2 it is half, Y3 to this one is half. Now the given problem is to find the rate of transmission. So rate of transmission is I of X comma Y into the symbol rate. So first we need to find I of X comma Y. So I of X comma Y is given by the formula H of Y minus H of Y by X. So we are going to use these two formula to find the given problem, that is rate of transmission. So now first we'll find what is this H of Y by X equal to. So to find that, we need to find P of X comma Y, which is P of Y by X into P of X. So we are going to multiply the probability value and write P of X comma Y. So it is P of X 1 is half, so 3 by 4 into half we are going to get 3 by 8. Next value will be 1 by 8, 0, 0, half into half 1 by 4, then 1 by 4. So this is the joint probability matrix P of X comma Y. So we'll try to solve it now. So now P of Y by X is given by the matrix. You have 3 by 4, 1 by 4, 0, 0, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. And P of X comma Y is given by the matrix 3 by 8, 1 by 8, 0, 0, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. And we know that H of Y by X is nothing but double summation I varying from 1 to R, J varying from 1 to S, P of Xi comma Yj into log of 1 by P of Yj by Xi. So we'll try to substitute this in the formula, that is P of Xi comma Yj will be 3 by 8 into log of 1 by 3 by 4. Similarly, 1 by 8, that is P of this joint probability matrix, will be taken as a scalar quantity and this will be the log function to that respective value. So finally, what we are going to get is H of Y by X after substitution, we are going to get it as 0.90564 bits per symbol. So this is your h of y by x. Now to find h of y, we need to find what is h of y1, h of y2, sorry, p of y1, p of y2 and p of y3. So now adding the elements of this particular joint probability matrix column wise, okay, we are going to add the element column wise, we are going to get the output symbol probability. So therefore we are going to get p of y1 equal to 3 by 8. P of y2 will be equal to 3 by 8. P of y3 will be equal to 1 by 4. Now using this probability value, we can find h of y, which is summation j varying from 1 to s p of yj into log of 1 by p of yj. So after substituting the values of probability, h of y will be equal to 1.56128 bits per symbol. So this is h of y. Now we have got h of y by x. Therefore we can write mutual information I of x comma y is h of y minus h of y by x. Substitute, you are going to get I of x comma y as 0.65564 bits per symbol. Now the question asked is rate. So RT is I of x comma y into RS. RS is 10,000 symbols per second. So multiply there. So finally you are going to get RT as 655.4 bits per second. So multiply this with 10,000, you are going to get it around here, 4 digit value. So you are going to get 655.64 bits per second as the rate of transmission. Third problem, a message produces two independent symbols A and B with probabilities P of A equal to 0.4 and P of B equal to 0.6. Calculate the efficiency of source and hence its redundancy. If the symbols are received in an average of 4 in every 100 symbols in error, calculate the transmission rate of the system. So what is given in the problem is, so P of A is given as 0.4, P of B is given as 0.6, and the probability and what is asked from this is find the efficiency of source. So efficiency of source is given as h of input symbol probability, that is h of x divided by h of x max, and the redundancy will be R eta s, which is equal to 1 minus efficiency. So first we'll find this. So h of x is nothing but p of a into log of 1 by p of a plus p of b into log of 1 by p of b, because we have two probabilities given here. So this will be equal to 0.97095 bits per message symbol. So this is the entropy for the given source. So h of s x max is nothing but, how many symbols are there? Two symbols are there. So it is log q. So log 2, which will be equal to 1 bits per symbol. Therefore we can write source efficiency equal to 0.97095 divided by 1, or it is 97.095%. Therefore redundancy will be 1 minus eta s. So efficiency R eta s will be 1 minus that. So it comes to around 2.905%. So we have got what is source efficiency and what is source redundancy. Now to find the transmission rate, it is given that the probability of error is 4 symbols for every 100 seconds. So we can write probability of error is equal to 4 symbols for every 100 symbol there is an error. so it will be equal to 0.04. So this is nothing but P. So if you try to write the channel diagram, it is a binary channel. So with the input as say A and B, and the output let it be say A dash, and let it be say B dash. If you try to see, this is the probability of error. So this will be 0.04, and this will be the probability of error for this, so 0.04, and the remaining probability will be 0.96, and this will be 0.96. So now if you take this as the input, let it be say x1 x2 y1, y2, we can write the channel matrix as P of y by x, which will be equal to x1, x2, y1, y2. So the matrix will be, you will have the 0.96, 0.04, 0.04, and 0.96. So this is the binary channel where the input values are given as P of x1 will be equal to P of A, which is equal to 0.4, P of x2 is nothing but P of B, which is 0.6. So we can write the joint probability matrix as P of x comma y, where we are going to multiply this first row with the P of A and second row with P of B. So after multiplication, we are going to get the matrix as first row with the 0.4. So 0. We'll just write it here. 0.96 into 0.4. Then this is 0.04 into 0.4. This row element will be 0.04 into 0.6, and this will be 0.96 into 0.6. So this will be the joint probability matrix. Now we know that mutual information I of x comma y is nothing but, since it is symmetric, we can write it as h of y minus h of y by x. So this h of y is from the joint probability matrix element, where we need to add this column. So we can write P of y1 is equal to add this column element. So you are going to get, after this addition, you are going to get P of y1 is equal to 0.96 into 0.4 plus 0.04 into 0.6. So you will get this value as 0.408. similarly, P of y2 will be equal to 0.04 into 0.4 plus 0.96 into 0.6. so it will be equal to 0.592. so from these two elements, we can find what is h of y equal to, which is, so P of y1 is solved and we have got it as 0.408. P of y2 we have solved and we have got it as 0.592. therefore, h of y will be equal to summation I varying from 1 to 2 P of yj into log 1 by P of yj, as per the formula. So it is going to be around some value. Okay, so you just solve it and find what is h of y equal to. Now I of x comma y is nothing but h of y minus h of y by x. Now this h of y by x will be a constant value, which is given as h because it is a symmetric channel. So we can write the value as, finally we can write it as 0.408 into log of 1 by 0.408 plus 0.592 into log of 1 by 0.592, which is h of y, minus minus a constant value where the elements are 0.04. For this 0.04 and 0.96. So we'll just substitute that value here. So which is 0.04 into log of 1 by 0.04 plus 0.96 into log of 1 by 0.96. Because it is symmetric, it is p bar into log 1 by p bar plus p into log 1 by p. So after solving, we are going to get the value as 0.7331 bits per symbol. So this is the mutual information for the given problem. Now the question asked is rate of transmission, which is I of x comma y into RS. So RS is nothing but it is told that there are 1000 symbols per second. So we are going to multiply 0.7331 into 100. So it will be equal to RT will be equal to, after multiplication, it will be 73.31 bits per second. This is the rate of transmission for the given problem.